Allah said in the Quran, in Surah Maryam, Surah number 19, and number 88, 89, 90, and 92, وَقَالُوا اتَّقَذَ الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدًا, and they say that the Most Gracious has begotten a son. لَقَدْ جَيْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا, it's the dirtiest thing that anyone can utter against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to say that Allah has a illegitimate child. لَقَدْ جَيْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتِ يَتَفَتَّرْنَاهُ مِنْهُ, if we give the sense of what they utter against the Almighty God Allah, the heaven will burst upon them. وَتَنْشَقُ الْأَرْضُ, the earth will split open and take them inside. وَتَقِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدَّا, the mountains will fall down in utter ruin. Why? أَنْدَوْ لِلْرَحْمَانِ وَلَدَا, because they boasted and they said that the Most Gracious has begotten a son. Therefore, Allah reacted and said, Allah does not beget children. And then, you see the miracle of the Quran? See, choice of word is very important. Sir said that the incest cases are metaphorically mentioned, but the results were practical. Cases have been mentioned metaphorically, results came practically. And he said, prophecy is fulfilled. Do you know another prophecy is unfulfilled when I quoted? I forgot it. Thank you, sister, for reminding me. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 23, verse number 2, where it says, B-A-S-T-A-R-D, till their 10th generation should not enter into the temple of the God. I told you about the genealogy given of Jesus in Matthew chapter number 1, verse number 3. There, the Pares, they made it, it's Pares in Old Testament, it became Pares here, so that the scent, the original scent of the name doesn't go to anybody. Pares becomes Pares. And this Pares, he is not from the 10th generation of that illegitimate child. He is before that. Again, Bible's prophecy is unfulfilled. Now, in the Quran, there is one attribute that is constantly used in the Bible to refer to the Almighty God. The Father. Abba. Abba. Abba na. Hamare baap. Hamare Abba. Our Father. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came, Allah knew, Allah knows, sir was right, Allah knows all the future. Allah knew that people are literally taking the word father, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam delete the word father from the Quran. Instead of Abbana, Allah gave the beautiful word Rabbana, our Lord, not our father, our cherisher, not our father, Rabbana, not Abbana, Rabbana. But who is this Rabbana? Allah. Who is Allah? Can you call Allah by any name? No. You can't call. Can I call anybody sitting here? Respected Elder Pastor Ranjit Ofir, he has got his identification. I cannot call him Tommy, Julie, anything. He has his own identification. If I can't call him by that name, I can't call God by any name. Allah said in the glorious Quran in Surah Bani Israel, Surah number 17, ayah number 110, خُلِدُ اللَّهَ عَبِدُ الرَّحْمَانِ أَيَّمَّا تَدْعُوا فَلَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى, call upon him Allah, or call upon him the Most Gracious. All the most beautiful names belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not corrupted names. Jesus is not Allah. The moment you say Isa, Jesus, you get a picture of a creation, not the creator. الرَّحْمَانِ, it's a perfect name. Elohim, Yahweh, Jehovah are not the perfect names of Almighty God. Allah, the perfect name. Allah is derived from the root Arabic word Ilah. Elohim, Ilah. From Ilah, it's Allah. Our kalima is La Ilaha. There is no God. Illa Allah, except the God. Who is the God? Allah, Al-Ilah. Who is this Al-Ilah? Ilah, the Arabic word, has got basically six meanings. One of them is Al-Malu. What is Al-Malu? Al-Malu means the Almighty God towards whom the whole creation rushes in utter love for their own peace. Ilah means one who cannot be seen by the creation. Ilah means one who is the most loving and benevolent. Ilah means one about whose power you are told You become amazed at it. Ilah means one towards whom the creation rushes at times of love, peace, as well as at times of problems. And if you want to call Allah by any other name, most welcome, as long as the attribute and the name you call Allah with should be absolute and perfect. It should not be corrupted. When we say Ilah, His power should amaze everybody. When you say Ilah, you should not get a picture where the God is on the cross crying, Allahi, Allah, Allah, Lama Sabaktini, oh God, why have you forsaken me? And then I am the God. This is not the imagination of God. Allah, that is Allah, the one who is most powerful, who is no other Ilah is near Him. All other Ilah are false gods. I hope I answered your question, sister.